It was the first full day of the Future of Educational Technology Conference in Orlando, Florida. Our opening keynote was from none other than Sal Khan, the founder of the world-renowned Khan Academy. From humble beginnings tutoring his cousins to inspiring millions, Khan Academy had improved the outcomes of students around the world. I was curious about how video-based learning could be applied to 21st century skills and how they work in different cultural contexts.
The tragedy that happens actually happens more likely in like upper income families, because they schedule every moment of children's lives oftentimes.
Yeah.
That you
exactly.
know, creativity is actually a side effect of boredom sometimes.
Yeah, it's
so
true.
If
it's
you have
true.
Every moment of your life scheduled, yeah. Then there's actually no space.
You're not
going to
have any room. Do you see it like culturally being adjusted based on the different regions that you go into?
Yeah, I mean, math, even on a context, a word problem, so to speak, a story problem,
yeah.
That oftentimes the context has to be adapted.
Right.
And obviously the humanities, there's a lot more that has to be thought through, because the cultural context and matters a lot.
Some of my most creative moments have come when I was bored. Sal's comment about global education made me curious to learn more about how we teach students about online behavior in the classroom. To do this, I met up with Digital Citizenship in Action author, Dr. Kristen Mattson.
I'm here with Kristen Mattson. She is the author of Digital Citizenship in Action. Increasingly, when a student grows up,
yeah.
they're becoming a citizen not only of the place that they live, but also
right.
online.
My book, Digital Citizenship in Action, is actually aimed at 6th through 12th grade classroom teachers, and
okay.
it's full of ideas for helping kids actually get immersed into different online communities,
mm-hmm.
and then working with them to teach them the skills of how to navigate those communities. So
right.
whether it comes down to having respectful dialogue online, as soon as we're handing students a device, we should be having digital citizenship conversations. Of course, we want to build a filter in between our kids' ears, right? And not just rely on a technology filter to catch our kids doing wrong things. But
yeah.
I also like to remind parents that childhood is a really safe time to learn and make mistakes. And so instead of having that knee-jerk reaction when mistakes happen, we need to celebrate the fact that our kids are getting a learning opportunity while they're young, so that they have the guidance of us as parents and teachers to kind of show them a better way, rather than restricting and waiting until they're adults, when those mistakes can be a lot more costly.
Kristen showed us how digital citizenship starts with showing that you care about others online. I loved the interactive cards activity she made for discussing online scenarios and digital citizenship in the classroom. I wanted to dive deeper into youth culture, and so I sought out engaging education blogger Nancy Blair Black to learn about keeping students interested.
I'm here with Nancy Blair Black, and she's a speaker and author.
I'm really excited about that session called Teach All the Memes, of course, in meme fashion.
Yeah.
And excited because I'll be actually co-presenting that with my 18-year-old daughter, Lainey Blair, who is also a social media guru. So I
yes.
think it's really important, you talked about understanding and connecting with youth culture.
Mm-hmm.
I think when we're doing that, we don't want to be doing that in isolation. And so I think for us as educators, if we really want to understand and connect with our students, we need to understand the languages that they're speaking in, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we're trying to teach them literacy with written language, with digital literacy, but there also is this meme literacy, understanding the common icons,
okay,
the
yep.
visual images, the things.
I see. So it's like
that,
another language.
That they're speaking.
Memes are really interesting and they're fun. I can understand why kids really love it. But when a teacher uses it, does it feel patronizing? Does it feel like You're kind of missing, like, especially because they're really sensitive to, you getting it wrong and not using the meme in the right way. So does it feel like, you've got to be very sensitive to how you write it?
When I was growing up, one of my youth leaders used to say this, and it has stuck with me and is something I truly live by, which is he would say, if you're not cool, don't try to be, all right? And
yeah.
this is, one of my life mantras, which is kind of funny, but it's if you're not cool, don't try to be.
Yeah.
If you're trying to be cool in front of your students in a way that's inauthentic, that shows through.
And what about like the use of mobile devices? I mean, it's often a fear, like a lot of teachers don't allow mobile devices inside. Like, what's your perspective on the use of mobile devices in the classroom?
at certain ages, it is appropriate for students to have access to phones, to tablets, to those other devices. And, you know, but my kindergartners wouldn't need to have access to a phone during the day. They're going to be just fine playing, you know. So, but when we get to high school and especially adolescence, it's actually a strong need of adolescents to connect. That social aspect, it's not just a want that they have. So we want to think about ways that we can be respectful to those students and to acknowledge that that's a need that they have in their life while helping them to engage in the classroom and in learning and in balancing both their academic responsibilities and later their professional responsibilities with their personal needs and personal responsibilities.
So it was a real pleasure to connect with Nancy Black because she's really thinking hard about how to make education very relevant for younger individuals. And I just loved her approach of kind of making education fun.
Nancy made an interesting observation about the connection between youth culture and memes as a way to show that you care about your students without trying to be something that you're not.
Hey, thanks so much for watching. If you'd like to see more videos like this, please subscribe. And if you'd like to be notified when new videos come out, click the bell.